Hey everybody, and welcome to a really quick Cricut tutorial. I wanted to bring you this tutorial because we have a brand new tool in Cricut Design Space. We are using the brand new background remover tool. So what I'm going to do is show you guys how to use it. Click upload and then click upload image. I'm going to just select an image from a Disney movie that I have that has a background on it so that you guys can see how well this works. So I'm just using this image from Soul. I'm gonna choose complex and click continue. Now you'll notice that the left side is very, very different now. You'll see that they are introducing you to your background remover tool, but you also still have the crop tool if you select the little square with the line through it. But we wanna use the background remover tool. So you have the automatic, which is quick and easy way to remove backgrounds from images. Now, this is only available for Access members. So if you're not an Access member, you will not have the automatic remover tool, but you can still use remove.bg. So what I'm gonna do is just click remove background. Now this does take a few seconds, so don't worry if it takes a little while. It is a little bit slow, but I expect that when it's trying to do something like this. Once it's removed your background, you can see it does a pretty good job. But let's say that we want everything to be connected and we kind of want like an outline around them of the background. You can simply click on erase because the restore doesn't work until you erase something, which is just silly. So I'm just gonna click one little spot over down here in the corner and then I can access the restore button. I'm gonna go ahead and change the size of my brush up to about 54, that should be fine. And all I need to do is I can just run my eraser tool wherever I want to restore parts. So if I want to restore some of the background, I can do that. It's really up to you how you use it. Maybe it erased something you didn't want it to, something like that. This is a terrible outline, but you get the idea. That way you can kind of make everything come back wherever you want it to. So that's kind of a cool thing. So if it either accidentally erases something you didn't want it to, or you want to put something back together, whatever you want to do, kind of like these guys, you want them all connected, you can do that. Then you can go through and you can erase anything that you want, just like you used to be able to. And then you also have the select tool where you can kind of click on it and it will go away. If you didn't want to do that, you can go ahead and just use the undo button just like before. There are more options down here, which is again, still your color tolerance and all of that. So that's still like it used to be. And then you also have a preview cut image option. So you'll see here, you can see the outline where it's going to cut. I'm gonna go ahead and hide the cut image, click apply and continue. And from here, you can either choose it as the cut image or you can use it as the print then cut image and click upload. Obviously you can change your image name, use tags, whatever you wanna do. It's really up to you and how you want to save it. And then I'll just show you what it looks like uploaded into the canvas. So click on it, click add to canvas, and it will upload your image. I'm not sure how big this one's gonna be. Not too bad. So that is all you really have to do. The background remover tool is really easy. I've tried it on a couple things. It seems to work pretty well, but let's go ahead and try it on something that has a white background. So I'm gonna click browse again, and we'll just use this image because I know this has a white background and it's got a lot of little spots. So let's see how it does with a black and white image. Click continue and then all I'm gonna do is click remove background. Let's see how it does. That looks pretty good, but I'm gonna preview the cut image to see what the edges look like. Honestly, it looks really, really good. I think it did a nice job. It even got this little tiny spot in the E on his signature. So what I'm gonna go ahead and do is just leave it as is, click apply and continue. And this one I wanna save as a cut image. Now you will notice the cut image looks thicker than the print then cut. It's because it shows you the cut lines, but it'll cut pretty thin. Click upload, then again, select it and add to canvas. That way we can just get a better look at how it did. It did a really good job. I think honestly for the image that I used, it's definitely like a handwritten image. It looks fantastic. The new background remover tool is going to be super handy, but again, it's only available for Access members. I'll link down below where you can grab Cricut Access from if you don't have it and want to get it. But again, you can always just use remove.bg as well as an option when it comes to removing backgrounds on images. I hope this helped you guys with the brand new background remover tool. If you have any questions, please let me know in those comments down below. I'm always happy to answer those for you. Be sure to subscribe to my channel. I put out new videos all the time. This one's just a nice little bonus since we got the new background remover tool. I hope you guys have a great day and happy crafting!